What's going on, everyone? It's Danny from the Texas Trailhead. Welcome to another YouTube little review, recap, first impressions video. I just got my hands on my very first pair of Danners. These are the Danner Free Spirits. It's kind of like a retro model design. According to the website, in the 1980s, hiking shoes started to become a little bit more fashion than just function, so you started to see the trend of people wearing them a little bit more often day to day. So this is a little bit of a throwback model, one of the newest styles. I happened to be in Colorado a few months ago doing a little bit of work. I was visiting the Outdoor Retailer Conference and they had just opened a new store in Denver downtown, so I was pretty stoked to go check out the store and check out some of these shoes in person for the very first time. And ever since then, I've been really wanting to get my hands on a pair, and I finally found some that they had my size in. These have been kind of tough to get. I've had a couple models, some trail runners that I wanted to get, but my size just never became available, which is good. It means a lot of people are heading outdoors, but I decided to go with these and try out another pair of hiking boots, so to speak. I do have some Merrell Moab mid hikers that I wear a little bit more day to day. So I'm excited to kind of walk you through these and let you know some of my general first impressions. First impressions only because I've worn them just to run errands. I've worn them to work, but at work I have a pretty hard surface that I stand on all day. So I figured that'd be a good way to check them out for comfort. So yeah, let's get into it and see what I think about these new Danner hiking shoes. So if you're familiar with the website, you know that I'm a pretty big fan of trail runners. I cycle through them pretty quickly and I just kind of like shoes in general, so I have a few different options. I like trail runners because I tell people I've got skateboard ankles and I really like that I can kind of wiggle around on some of the rockier terrain that you're gonna find in Central Texas, which is where I live. There's a lot of rocks that you have to be mindful for. And if you trip, I like the option to have my foot and ankle bend accordingly. I've always felt that in boots, if that happens, your whole body is gonna tilt with you. But I wore my Merrell Moabs when I did the Guadalupe Peak Trail for my birthday this year and had a pretty good experience with them. So I've been kind of using them back and forth. So I got another pair of traditional hiking boots. Yeah, so far so good, I like them. One of the things with this Free Spirit model from Danner is you're gonna get that retro feel, that retro vibe, the green that you're gonna see in some of Danner's other models, and then you're gonna get the suede uppers, which is gonna create some durability there with the outer part of your shoe. And then the green area is gonna be the Gore-Tex mesh, which is, according to the website, gonna allow for more breathability. And that's a very important part. When I'm talking about hiking shoes, breathability is gonna be key. So you're gonna wanna have really comfortable socks to wick away moisture and dry quickly. But the thing that I've always kind of talked about with not wanting waterproof shoes to hike in is if you do get water in your shoes, they're not really gonna dry that quickly. So it's counterproductive. Your feet are gonna have moisture in them. They're gonna rub a lot easier and you're gonna be more prone to blistering. With this model of the Gore-Tex shoes, they do claim that there is gonna be some added breathability in those two. I haven't been able to test that out yet, so I'm hoping to add that to a follow-up full hiking review, so stay tuned for that. But from what I've worn them so far, my feet haven't overheated. I've worn them indoors, but I work retail full-time, and so I'm always running around, and my feet do get hot while I'm at work, so I haven't really noticed that with the suede and the Gore-Tex, that mesh kind of lining on them. So far, so good. One of the things for added comfort for these Free Spirit shoes is the removable ortholite footbed. Some people like a lot of cushions, some people don't need as much and want their feet to just be able to live in the boot. Coming from trail runners, when I first saw these and saw the outer cushion on the bottom of the boot, I did expect them to be a little bit more cushy, so to speak. That wasn't what I got in my first impression. I stepped into them thinking they would be really plush, like the trail runners that I wear normally. And the Ortholite footbed was specifically designed, it turns out, to not do what I thought it was gonna do. So with this footbed, you're gonna get a little bit, and without getting into the scientific terms, but you're gonna get a little bit of that squish in the middle part of your feet, but have a little bit more density on the outer parts of your feet. And this is gonna create a little bit more stability while your foot is in the shoe and not have it move around so much while you're hiking. And this is gonna be important on kind of rockier terrain and just terrain that's gonna have your foot kind of bending in a couple different directions. And according to the website, that footbed is gonna allow for more heat dissipation and circulation. So added comfort and breathability. And one of the things I noticed right off the bat when I took these shoes out of the box was the Vibram sole on the bottom. So the Vibram sole is gonna create some added traction, but the tread on the bottom was really cool. You're gonna see these triangular designs that are on the lugs themselves. I'm just kind of looking at them. And the way they're spread out is gonna give you a little bit more traction while you're hiking. One of the things that I was a little bit disappointed with my Merrells when I was hiking at the Guadalupe National Park was that the Vibram sole itself didn't really provide that much traction. And there was a couple rocks and instances where I stepped and my foot just completely slid off of the rock. So I understand Vibram is not gonna be a magnet for rocks, but I did hope that I was gonna get a little bit more traction. But this tread is a little bit different. And so it should provide a lot more grip. So on the ground, flat surface, obviously, I'm not gonna notice it too much, but the Vibram soles, you can feel a little bit of stickiness when you're walking on certain surfaces. I'm not always in trail runners or hiking shoes. Sometimes I do wear a cowboy boot or a roper, if you're familiar with those. And one of the things that make those unique is the stitching that is used to connect the boot itself to the heel and to the sole. And you actually see a little bit of that stitching on the back of this boot, on the back of this hiking shoe, and that's gonna create a little bit more stability and just a little bit more of a solid feel when you're hiking and create that extra protection when you're walking downhill too. And the back of the heel does have a little bit of a rubber heel cap as well. On the front of this boot, you're gonna see a pretty sizable toe cap as well. When I'm looking for shoes to hike in Texas, I really, really need a substantial toe cap because of the rocks that I had mentioned earlier. My feet don't come up very high when I'm hiking and I hit my toes on a lot. So if they don't have a good toe cap, I'm not gonna wear them at all because I'm gonna smash my feet. And one of the things that I noticed when I was wearing these hiking shoes, right off the bat, you have that suede, and then that suede is covered, and then you have the toe cap. And it feels pretty sturdy. If you've ever worn like a fishing wading boot, it felt a lot like that. And I felt pretty confident and secure. Felt confident and knowing that my toes were secure was a really good feeling too. So because these are a leather hiking shoe, they are gonna have a little bit of added weight. The boot itself is weighing in at about 37 ounces for the entire pair. So if that's something you're concerned about, there you go, that's the weight. The lacing system is gonna be pretty straightforward. You're gonna have the metal rings. This really helps to kind of gauge in the tightness I found when you're lacing up the shoes. So the laces slide easily. And they also come with an additional pair of shoelaces too. So if you don't like this particular color that comes with it, you can switch it to a flatter lace and change up the aesthetic as well. Danner also has a bunch of different laces that you can buy separately on their website and in their stores. One of the things that I liked about Danner and feeling confident in my purchase is the warranty that Danner has. They have a 365-day warranty against any defects. And I know that in some styles, they do have a repair program in place. So I'll put the link to Danner in the description so you can learn more about their warranty. But I'm excited to wear these a little bit more and get them out on the trails and see how my feet feel on some rocky conditions. So stay tuned.